Good morning. Welcome to class this morning. Get a little situated. Get the extra wiggles out. Roll your shoulders. Forward and back, round in circles. Do some big circles with your torso. Rolling around on your sit bones and make sure you go both ways. And rock side to side, lifting and lowering your glute to your hip. Kind of waving your upper body side to side so you get that opening on the side of your spine. And then bring yourself to center, root through your sit bones. Make sure that your pelvic bowl is level so you don't have your back arched forward, which would be your pelvic bowl dipping, spilling forward, and you're not sitting back in the chair so that your pelvic bowl is spilling backwards. Small and tuck of the abdominal wall or control of the abdominal muscles. Lengthen through the crown. Take a nice big breath. Exhale it out. Maintain erect spine. Let's flip our hands over, palms up, closing our eyes and coming into our breath. Making your breath a little bit bigger than your natural breath, so a little bit of control. Remembering the quote that I put on for today's class was that patience is not passive waiting. Patience is active acceptance of the process. When we have our palms up, it's kind of a receiving gesture. Just imagine yourself receiving acceptance of whatever the process is you have going on right now. Maybe it's the process of sitting still and breathing. Maybe this exact process you are trying to come to acceptance with. Maybe it's not your favorite part. Maybe it's a situation, a person, circumstances. Imagine yourself receiving acceptance. Drop your head forward, just a soft drop forward. Slide the back of your hands as far down the spine or down the thighs as it's comfortable. So you're not really reaching, you're not lifting them up. Just extending your arms out, keeping your head dropped forward. Slowly roll your neck over to the left, stacking your ear on top of the shoulder. Lift your chin slightly, give it a little more to the front of the neck, and then turn the head, taking the chin towards the clavicle, moving the stretch into the back of the neck. Lifting the chin, go nice and slow. Feel the stretch move along the side of the neck towards the front, towards the throat. You lift your chin. Then rotating your chin downward, nice and slow. Feel the stretch move along the neck towards the back next to the spine. Then draw the chin in a little bit tighter into the clavicle, into the voice box, and roll it back to center ever so slowly. Bring the head up to neutral, stack it on top of the spine, and then do a nice big no side to side. Not too fast, not too slow. Head faces forward again and a gentle drop of the chin. Start to roll the neck to the right, stacking the right ear over the right shoulder. Lift the chin a little bit, stretch the front of the neck into the throat. And rotating, bringing the chin down towards the clavicle, moving the stretch into the back of the neck. Rotating a chin back up to the ceiling, take it slow. Let the stretch move across the side of the neck, lifting chin. Breathing and coming back down with the chin. Towards the clavicle, move the stretch to the back of the neck, right up next to the spine. Then tuck the chin in tighter into the clavicle. Slowly start to roll to center. Get to the center, lift your head back up and take big nose. Big side to side. Head facing forward, flip your hands back over, slide them up to your thighs, roll your shoulders around. Switch directions. All right, taking the left arm out to the side, palm is facing forward, wide fingers, jazz hand. Draw the shoulder forward first, like you're punching with your shoulder, and then start to slide the straight arm forward and across the body as far as you can go before you feel like you need to bend your elbow. Take your right arm and hook the forearm of the left, and draw it in, and then drop that left shoulder down and away from your ear. Keep the elbow strong. Don't let it break bend. Don't let it be too straight. Don't have it locked out. That's the word I'm looking for. Searching around all over for. Turn your head to the right. Turn your head back to forward. Release the right arm to the lap. Open the left arm back up, leading through the shoulder, the back of the hand. To the side, flip the hand over. So the palm is up, sorry. Bring the shoulder up to your ear and then bring the arm up and over. Reach towards the sky and then bend your elbow and let it hang out on the top of your head. You can stay tall or you can do a little lean right and open up that space between the rib cage and the hip bone. Or not, maybe you don't feel that today. If you lean, straighten back up. Lift your forearm off the top of your head. Wide fingers reach towards the ceiling and then slowly start lowering down until you're parallel with the floor again. Flip the palm all the way around to face the back wall. and then press back in space, opening to the back. Bring the arm back forward, right in line with the shoulder, bend the elbow, scarecrow, let it dangle. Check out your hand. Elbows locked in place, 90 degree. Start to slide it into the small of your back. Sit up tall so you don't arch your back. Engage your abs. Just rest it there. And drop the right ear over again. Bring the head back up. Slide the arm out all the way till it dangles. And then just shake it out. Return it to your lap. Roll your shoulders again. Big rolls. Go the other direction. All right, and relax. We're going to do all that, if I can remember the sequence, on the right side. So take the right arm out, parallel to the floor, wide jazz hand fingers. Bring the shoulder forward first, then start to slide the arm across the body. Elbow is micro bent, so it's not locked out. Go as far as you can, then hook that left arm into the forearm and pull in without bending your elbow, without trying to lock it. Keep the wide jazz fingers. Push that shoulder down away from the right ear. You're engaging your upper back and pushing it down. Tall erect spine, breathe. And release the left arm. Slide the right one open, back to parallel. Flip your hand so the palm is up. Bring the shoulder up to your ear. Oops, fans in the way, start to bring the arm up. Right next to your ear, reach the ceiling, then bend the elbow and just let that arm hang out on the top of your head. You can stay tall or have a little lean, a tiny one to the left. So glad this microphone is not on my belly, because for some reason my belly's really growling today. Center your spine back up if you leaned. Bring the arm back up to the ceiling, reach first, and then start to lower down to the side nice and slow till the arm is parallel with the floor. Rotate the hand arm all the way around so that it faces the back wall, wide jazz hand fingers, and press the arm back in space. And bring the arm back. Line it up with your shoulder, bend your elbow, scarecrow, relax your jazz hands. Let it hang out there. Start to slide that back of your hand into the small of your back. Sit up tall so you don't arch. Slide it back as far as you feel comfortable and then literally just relax it there. So since my haunches are up against the back of my chair, my arm is kind of hanging out on top of my haunches. Drop the left ear over to the left side. So this is a side that's bothering me from, I'm right-handed, so I'm doing lots of reaching and scrubbing with my right hand. And this doesn't feel the best. Hopefully it will feel better by the time we're done. Bring your head back up to neutral. Gently slide the arm out until it's dangling. Relax, hang it out, shake it out. Bring the hand back to your lap and shoulder roll again. Big shoulder roll. Other direction. And relax. Sit up nice and tall. We're going to do some rotations from side to side. So you're going to imagine that you have a rod right through your belly button into the back of the chair. So your rotation is going to be generated mostly from the upper body, not so much from the lower body. Obviously, it goes with it some, but we're going to try and not do so much in the lower body. The lower back is the most mobile, other than the neck, of course. It's the most mobile, but it's also the most prone to injury because of the high mobility rate. So lengthen nice and tall. Then start with your chin to the 45 degree angle. And then start to think about your breastbone, finding that happy medium between the 45 and where the belly is facing forward. So the chest breastbone is going to be somewhere in the middle of this radius. That makes sense? You don't have to have your arm up there. That was just my 45. Lengthening tall. Relax your shoulders. This isn't a shoulder initiated twist. This is a back initiated twist. Breathe. And then continue your head on over the right shoulder. Now, once you're in this position, you can stabilize yourself by grabbing the chair and holding on, but don't yank. That makes sense. Give the back muscles a little bit of break by stabilizing with your arm. Bring your head back to 45 first. Release your arms and bring your chest back to face center. Then bring your head back to face center and roll. You can roll or you can round your whole back forward and back, whichever you want to do, whatever feels good. From intuitive motion. All right, sit back up tall. We're going to do the other side. Everything is facing directly forward. Turn the head left 45 degrees first, right out in that area. Chest and belly button are still facing directly forward. Think of that breastbone coming halfway between that 45 and forward. In order to keep that belly button from twisting too much with it, engage through that core, through those abs. Try and relax your butt. Your butt sometimes wants to try and grip the seat as you rotate. Relaxed arms. Turn your head further over the left shoulder, keeping the torso in alignment that it's in. Now you can use those arms to stabilize without yanking. Kind of pressing down and sitting up taller. Holding on if you need to hold on, but try not to yank. And breathe and all that fun stuff. Bring your head back to 45 first. Relax your arms. Bring your chest back to face forward. And bring your head back to face forward. Roll, round, whatever your body wants. A little more twist. Now we're going to do some twist with our legs crossed. So you have a couple of options. You can come forward a little bit or you can stay. You can cross your feet only. You can go to figure four or you can cross your whole leg and cross leg. Whichever one you want to do. Obviously, the more crossed you are, the more stretch it will be in various places, various positions. Totally up to you. So sit up nice and tall to start. Arms are relaxed. You can also, if it interests you, You can get a strap and either put it on the floor for figure four, put it on the floor foot, or you can put it up above your ankle and hold on to it to help so that you're not squeezing, you're not using so much thigh muscle in order to keep the leg up there. Even in cross leg position, you can hold on to it like so. So those are options that you have as well for support. Sitting up nice and tall, we're going to go across the right leg. So turn the head 45 first, up in that area. Then bring the chest about halfway between, keeping the belly forward, so draw the abs in. Turn the head over the right shoulder. Then use the arms for support if you not want without yanking. Without yanking on your leg, without yanking on the chair. Chin down, look down. Chin up, look up. Chin back to neutral. Bring the head back to 45. Relax the arms and bring the chest back to center. Head to follow. Switch legs. Roll around a little bit if you need to in between your switching. Figure out which direction you want to go or which cross you want to do, ankles, figure four, or cross legs. Sit up nice and tall, head to 45 first to the left. So we're going to go over the left leg. Rotate the chest about halfway. And if you have flexibility to go the whole 45 without using your arms, that's the key. Don't use your arms, don't use your shoulders. Keep the belly button face forward. Turn the head over the left shoulder. Then place your arms pressing down to lift up. Breathe. Head back to 45. Relax the arms, chest back forward, head to follow. Release the leg, shake it out. We are going to come forward on the seat of our chair and we are going to take, turn our whole body to the right, one leg on, or one cheek on, one cheek off. You can be on your toes on the dropped leg, or you can be with a blanket underneath your shin or underneath your ankle or a pillow or whatever feels supported if you feel like you need support. Knee right under hip, hip right under shoulder. Peek in the mirror or the camera or something like that if you need to. Our tendency sometimes is to take the leg too far back. Get it all lined up. Take a nice deep breath. Squeeze the drop glute, tuck the tail slightly, draw the belly in. Left arm, outside arm, inhale up to the ceiling. Keep the shoulder down away from the ear. Bend the elbow, let it hang out over the top of your head. Breathe. Bring the arm back down to parallel. Slide it across the front of the body towards the back of the chair. Upper body twist, pull the belly in. Pull the belly in. You can't reach the top of the chair. You can just rest it on the thigh, the right thigh. Or you can rest it on the top of the chair, but don't yank. Please don't yank. Trying to get out of yanking. Slowly come back forward to center. Relaxed arms, relaxed glutes, slide the leg up, walk ourselves around to the other side. One cheek on, one off. Drop the knee up on the toes or supported. Try and do the same on both sides. You may not be able to if you have an injury or if you have surgery on one and not the other. Scarring, any of that sort of thing. Make sure your shoulder is over your hip and your hip is over your knee. Move the leg forward and back to make that position happen. Sit up nice and tall, take a deep breath. Exhale, squeeze that drop glute, press that hip forward. Stay tall. Outside arm, right arm, inhale up. Drop the shoulder down away from the ear, bend the elbow, rest the forearm on your head. Lengthen and breathe. Straighten the arm, lower it to parallel with the floor, slide it across the front of the body with a nice twist, pull the belly in before you start twisting. Either rest the hand on the outside of the left thigh, or if you can touch the top of the chair, breathe. Relax the arm, bring your chest back facing forward, release the glute, slide the leg back up, walk yourself forward. And shake it all out. Spread the stuff. We're going to do some of our balance. So standing up, bring the chair to the side, whichever side is more comfortable. I want your feet touching, your bunions touching, if you're so blessed with them. Your ankles touching. I don't know why, but I've got like swollen ankles for some reason, like some sort of edema, I don't know. Squeeze your calves together, your knees together, your quads together. So when you squeeze all that together, you kind of lean a little forward, your butt sticks out a little bit. Squeeze your butt and lengthen up nice and tall. So it's going to challenge your balance just by squeezing everything together and remaining nice and tall. Shoulders are relaxed at your side. You can grab the chair if you need to, if you're getting wobbly. Find a focal point. Breathe. All right, you're going to bring one arm up. I don't care which one, whichever one's not closest to the thing you're holding on to. Bring it right up over your ear. Lengthen tall. Reach from the toes. Feel like you're lifting yourself up off the floor. Reach all the way up to the middle finger. Lengthen that body and then lean in the opposite direction. Just a bit. Squeeze the legs together. Squeeze the glutes. Hold on with that other hand if you need to. Breathe. And then line yourself back up, stacking over the soles of your feet. Relax that arm down. Keep squeezing the legs together. Find that focal point. Arms at your side, palms facing forward. You can hold on with that other hand if you need to. Lengthen through the crown. Relax the legs. We're going to do the other side. So you can either turn around, face the other direction, or move your hold on apparatus to the other side. Shake your legs out first. Walk them out a little bit, then bring those feet together, ankles together, calves together, knees together, thighs together, squeeze the butt. So your legs are all stacked up, your spine is nice and tall. Hold on to that, whatever you've got, if you need to. Find a focal point. Breathe. Arms are relaxed at your side. Now bring the other arm up. Right next to the head. Then reach with your fingertips. Feel as if you're pulling yourself up off the floor. Lengthening through each and every joint. Feeling your belly lengthening up. And then lean over just a bit. Find that focal point. Feel the rib cage pull away from the hip. Feel your balance being challenged. Squeeze through the thighs all the way down the inner leg. Squeeze the butt. Try not to lock out your knees. Try to breathe. Slowly come back up so everything is lined up. Slowly relax your arm down, keeping your balance, keep your focal point. Arms at your side, rotate so the palms are facing forward. Lengthen again through the crown of your head. Squeeze through your glutes, hollow out your belly. Hands on your hips. Bend the knees a teeny bit more than they already are. Keep squeezing through them. Flat back, hinge at your hips, come forward as far as you feel comfortable. You can take an arm and hold on if you need to. And then come back up, keep the knees bent. Bend the knees a tiny bit more. You bend the knees a tiny bit more, don't let the knees go out in front of the toes. So that means you need to slide your hips backwards a little bit, so that all the weight is evenly distributed from the heel of your foot to the toes of your foot. So don't go back too far. Deep breath. Hinge at your hips, come forward a little bit more. Check the balance, is it even over both feet front to back? If not, slide the hips back a little more. Don't go too far, keep weight on your toes. Pull the belly in, tall spine. Squeeze the thighs, squeeze the butt, and slowly come all the way up tall standing. Walk your feet out. Good stuff. All right, we're going to go to the floor. Can't say my shoulder is better, but it's mobile. It was not mobile when I got out of bed this morning. Make your way to the floor onto your back. You don't need any props unless you want them. We're gonna twist to the side, so you might want a block or pillow nearby. Walk your feet to the outside edges to start and just do a little flopping, releasing any tension in your hips and thighs. Walk your feet together, hip width apart. Comfortable distance away from your glutes. Arms on the floor, palms down, shoulders level, kind of round the tops of your shoulders, kind of lift up a little bit and roll the tops of your shoulders down, and then place your whole upper back down. It opens up the front of your chest a little bit more. That made absolutely no sense. Try to imagine that someone is pulling your shoulder blades down towards your butt. You're trying to lower that upper back down towards the butt. But keeping the palms of your hands on the floor. The tendency is that when you roll the shoulders down, your palms want to roll upward to face the ceiling. Roll them back down to press into the mat. Squeeze the glutes. Imagine you have that block between your knees, ball between your knees, or you can actually put something between your knees if you want. Pillow. Keeping your knees and your toes lined up. Squeeze the butt. Lift the weight off of the floor. You keep your skin touching. For me, it's the excess derriere touching. And relax the weight back down onto the bones. Relax the thighs. Breathe one more time. Squeeze through the butt. Engage the thighs. Hold whatever's between your legs, imaginary or real, and lift the weight off of the mat from your hips. Don't have to lift very high. Skin flab can still touch. Squeezing through the glutes, rooting through the soles of the feet. Press through the toes. And slowly lower the weight back down onto your bones. Relax your thighs. We're going to do it again, but I want you to lift a little bit higher so maybe your butt skin's not touching. For lack of a better term, your meat suit's not touching. All right, squeeze your glutes. Press through your feet from heels to toes. Engage the thighs. Hold your thing between your legs. And lift your meat suit off of the floor from your glutes. Imagine that your knees are going towards the front of the toes. So your knees aren't lifting straight up. They're going down your body. Squeeze. Don't lift very high. Just let your meat suit come off the mat. Squeeze those glutes, strengthening through the hips, the thighs. Breathe slowly as if your body is a hard board behind it. Lower down all in one piece. Feel the meat suit touch, then relax into the bone. Roll side to side a little bit if you want to, or rock side to side is a better term. Straighten out the right leg. Keep the toes towards the ceiling. So keep it actively engaged. Bring the left knee up. Hold on the shin or back behind the thigh, whichever is more comfortable. Take a nice deep breath. Exhale, pull it in tighter, push through the right heel, lift your head nose to knee. And then slowly lower down. Relaxing the grip on the thigh, take your right hand on the outside of that left thigh. Press your left hand into the floor to help you roll to the right. Hips stay stacked. Flex both feet. Squeeze both glutes. Keep the hips stacked on top of each other rather than the top hip collapsing into the bottom hip. And we do that by keeping our legs active, keeping our butt active, feet active. Not a passive stretch. Breathe. Slowly roll yourself back. Return your right foot to the or left foot to the floor. Slide your right foot up. Slide your left foot out. Flex the left foot to keep the toes to the ceiling. Draw the right knee in, holding on the shin or the back of the thigh. Take a nice deep breath. Exhale, draw the knee in. Lift your head nose to knee and press the left heel into the mat. Slowly lower back down. Relax the grip on the leg. Left hand on the outside of right thigh. Press the right hand arm into the mat to help you roll left. Engage through both glutes, both thighs. Flex both feet. Keep hips stacked on top of each other instead of collapsing into each other. If you've ever watched a building be imploded, how it all kind of collapses down, they have these great techniques to make it collapse almost straight down. It just collapses down over each other. We don't want our hips to collapse down into each other. We're strengthening, not just stretching. Breathe. Slowly roll ourselves back. Return the right foot to the floor. Slide the left one up. Walk to the outside edges of your mat. Do some flopping. Twisting is really good for the digestive system. It helps things move through if it's feeling sluggish. It kind of massages the bowels, massages through the other organs, the liver, the belly. If you feel gassy or have any IBS or any of those kinds of things, sometimes a little twisting can help relieve some of the pressure, help move things around and release whatever's causing the pains. All right, get all your stuff together. Prepare yourself for Shavasana. Lining your hips and shoulders up. Giving your back some support, whether it be with a bolster or pillows under your knees. Putting your calves up on a chair or couch. Take a few more moments to get yourself situated using blanket, eye pillows, pillow for your head. And come into your breath. Once again, putting ourselves into a receptive position, allowing our palms to remain up. In whatever position you've chosen. Palms up is not only a receptive position, but it's a vulnerable position. Lying on the floor even is a vulnerable position. The front of your body is much more vulnerable than the back of your body. Although we're not like a turtle, we have some turtle-like aspects of the back of the body. A long or thoracic spine, or kind of upper to mid-back. Our individual vertebrae nestle into each other to create a hard shell covering for the heart and lung area, making it more difficult to penetrate. When you think about protecting in the midst of a storm or hurricane or tornadoes, you always think of covering over children and you're putting your back to whatever the threat is. It has much more dense muscles. It's stronger than the front. The rib cage is longer in the back part of the body than the front part of the body. The pelvic bowl is closed in the back and kind of more open in the front. If you think of looking at the pelvic skeleton. So the act of laying on the floor, everything open, can feel vulnerable, exposed. The backs of our wrists are much stronger than the front. The front of our wrists, the veins are close to the skin. You can see them, the purples and reds, sometimes blue colors of the veins. There's a reason that they do C-sections in the front of the body and not the back. It's easier to get to. There's a reason the doctor feels in your belly to feel the shapes of the organs. They're easier to reach, easier to get to. They do an exam, a physical exam of the body. The face is much more vulnerable than the back of the head. The throat is much more vulnerable than the back of the neck. Allow yourself to find comfort or acceptance in this vulnerability. Practicing moments of vulnerability when you know there is no threat, no impeding threat, can help you practice vulnerability when maybe there's verbal threat. Not necessarily physical harm, but emotional or mental. Helping to build that barrier, that shield. Finding our limit of vulnerability. And being open and receptive to the patience of the process. Not having patience is a form of not being, allowing ourselves to be vulnerable. Building up that acceptance, building up that mental fortitude, that strength and acceptance. Acceptance of another's choices. Acceptance of the circumstances or the process for things to get finished or completed, another person's schedule that may not align with yours. Whatever you do in life, never pray for patience because it will be tested. As your mind wanders around in these different thought processes, your body has naturally just released itself to the mat. Feel the vulnerable front of your body melted into the strong and sturdy back of the body. Feel the tips of the toes and the tips of the fingers. Feel the wrists and the ankles, elbows and knees, hips and shoulders. Take a nice deep breath. Exhale and wiggle fingers and toes. Open and close palms. Squeeze and release. Pumping blood back up the arm, up the calves. Opening and closing fingers and toes. Roll wrists and ankles, elbows and knees, shrug shoulders, squeeze butt, round back, turn your head side to side, wake the body back up. Gently draw one knee into your chest at a time. Give yourself a nice big hug if you'd like to. Roll around if you'd want to. Sit still. Gently roll over onto your side, stacking shoulders, hips, and knees. Make a nice long back, support your head. Where is your patience level today? What do you have before you today that you need patience for? What do you anticipate? Make the choice at this moment to wait with integrity, wait with ease, and to accept the process. Gently bring yourself back up, peeling off the mat, find a seat, relaxing your arms, cross-legged or straight-legged, it's up to you. Do some rolls with your shoulders, go both directions. Turn your head right and left. Keep the shoulders relaxed. Then take the head up and down. Shoulders relax. Relax your head. Deep breath with your arms. Inhale all the way up. Exhale all the way down. Another big breath all the way up. Hands come together overhead. Exhale them down to your chest as your eyes flutter open into the room. And namaste.